Okay, so what have I found? Obviously, you know in the last video the bottom subwoofer was rubbing. I managed to get it to unrub, so it's not blowing totally, but the damage is pretty severe. Basically, you have the voice coil coming out, it goes past the spider, and then it's glued to the diaphragm or the speaker itself. In between the coil and this part here where it's glued together, it has collapsed basically because it was driven so hard that the coil just started collapsing the back of it. Okay, it just looks like a. I'll take it out and show you what it looks like. It's actually starting to rip all around it because it's collapsed so badly on itself. The one on the top works, but it's not as bright as the one over here. Same with the mid-range and the tweeter. When I have this centered on the channels, this one's very, very, you can barely hear it. This one here is super loud, and it's not the amp. For me to get this to work good enough that you can hear them both, I have to turn this all the way over almost to the end and just give this one a touch to get that to work, which is, yeah. So basically, the whole speaker is fried. Even if I went out of the way and, you know, fixed that bottom subwoofer, it's not going to do any good because the whole thing is fried. I took it didn't take much to get into it. It's just a bunch of hot glue, and you can snap those rings off, put them back on. You wouldn't even know it was in there. But when you take the subwoofers out, I took a look at the really nice crossover on the back. I couldn't see any fried resistors or bad caps. So basically, the speakers just couldn't handle it. They definitely put more than 200 watts through the speaker. If I get cleared up with the guy, I basically want at least $500 back, or send me another speaker. If he gives me my $500, what I'll end up doing is I'll take one sub out of here, put it in there, and then I'll replace the two bottom ones with a different brand. And for the mid-range and tweeter, basically all that is their bookshelf speaker put in a bigger speaker box. So I'll basically pick up for 200, I'll pick up their bookshelf speakers, and basically just swap all four speakers, all drivers out. And there you go. I got a working speakers. I do not want to send these back. These weigh 65 pounds each. And what am I going to do? I'm going to throw them in the Honda, and they won't fit. The boxes are huge. I'm going to have to find someone with a hire someone with a truck. Then I'm going to have to get them to load it up. We'll have to order a dolly, and then I'll have to take it to the post office. Yeah, it's not going to happen. This is why this happened, because he knows I'm not going to send it back. Look at the guy's feedback. When I read that feedback before I bought them, I was skeptical. Maybe I'm thinking maybe the guy, maybe the previous buyers did something to fuck up the speaker or whatever. But no, this is a scam, because he's selling these speakers through Fluence. He's using their name to sell bad speakers. Basically, I noticed that when I took this out of the box, the stands weren't even installed yet, because I had to, like I said, you saw in the video, I had to actually poke the laminate to get to the threads so I can put the bases on. But one thing I did notice is I have a clean basement, a freshly painted floor. When I took these out, there was white scratches, like someone had, I don't know, like scooted them across the floor on some drywall, got stuck to it and left big white scratches on it. I didn't really put two and two together until now that I'm thinking about it. What someone did is they took these out of this box, drove the shit out of them, put them back in the box, and sent them back to the seller. And the seller just basically sold me someone else's bullshit. So we'll see how he's going to clear this up. But the only way I'm going to be able to fix it is to swap subs, replace the two subs in the bottom, and replace the mid and the tweeter, because they're totally fucked. So not a happy camper. Been a fun day and a half, stress, arguing back and forth with the seller. Well, I mean, he hasn't argued to me yet, but I've been basically giving him shit for this. When actually, I don't think it's his fault. This is definitely a manufacturer's defect, which I managed to fix. This is what happens when you source out your speakers out to China and have them reassembled and built, and then bring them back and sell them as Canadian made. The bottom sub, this isn't the first time this has happened, because if you look at the reviews and the link I left in the description, other people have had the same problem. I managed to fix the issue with the one channel being louder than the other. What it was is the interconnects in the back has a bridge, and it was dirty, and once I cleaned it up, put it back together and tightened it up, the top got louder, so now they're pretty much even. Now I don't have to mess with the balance on the receiver. But this one here still has an issue, which I'm going to show you. To get these rings off, they're actually pretty easy to get off. They're hot glued. You can see that huge pile there. That's all pretty much all they use. You're going to take a butter knife or something flat and not sharp, stick it in there and just give it a twist, and these will literally fly off. And that's basically all it is a piece of plastic. You're going to have hot glue here, 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 and here. You're going to make sure this is all totally clean before you try and pull that speaker out. The screws are basically, they look like drywall screws, but they're just thicker. And I can see why they use this type of screw. These speakers are thick, though. They're not thin and cheap. Here's the screw there. Well, give me a second to get this out, because the minute I take the last screw out, it's going to fall out. It's back heavy. So to give you an idea how thick the box is, it's pretty thick. And it does have a lot of bracing in three spots, actually. Not too bad. I can't give you a good shot of the crossover. The crossover is pretty nice. But these two subs work in series. So if there's a problem with one, the other one's not going to work either. But anyway, I'm going to show you the issue with the speaker and why it is manufacturer defect. Look at the size of that magnet in the back. That's nice. But if you look down there, let me get a light and give you a better look. As you can see, it looks like it's cut or folded there. That's an issue. The way these things were designed, you can see that seam there. They basically only bring the paper up to about there, and then they glue this piece to it. And in certain areas, it's got damage to it. Some other areas, it looks like it's someone pushed a lot of weight on here, and it just basically collapsed. I'm going to actually try and use a little shoe goo, because what you should be seeing is these little air holes all the way along there. But they're sort of buried in the spider because it's dropped down. So I'm going to try and fix it with glue. It's a rubberized glue. It should work. And give it some support, because other than that, it works. But to get it unjammed from rubbing on the coil, I had to actually push on the speaker. I was trying to figure out what was going on, why it was rubbing so bad. I thought maybe if I was to twist the cage, it would stop doing it. And then I was pushing up on the cone like that, and it literally pulled the voice coil right out of the magnet, and it was jammed. And then I jiggled it, it dropped back in. When it dropped back in, it stopped rubbing. So it works fine now. But as you can see, there is defect there, so I'm going to try gluing it and see if that helps. Well, there you go, guys. It's glued. I don't blame the seller. I blame Fluence for these defects. When you see more than one defect like this in the reviews, then you know that Fluence needs to change the way they're designing their speakers. They need to start sourcing it out to China and put a little bit more detail in their work. But that's definitely a manufacturer's defect. That'll dry as a hard rubber, so it's not going to come loose or bounce around in the speaker. I'm just going to give it an hour to cure before I start it up. you know what? I figured since we're here, we'll take them both out. I wanted to show you the crossover, which is very nice. There's the wire that bridges the two subs. Pretty thin. Flimsy looking. Whoops, sorry. There it is there. Pretty thin. Anyway, check out this crossover. This crossover is nice. Someone said that... So that what they did is they separated the top from the bottom, obviously, if it's mid-range. It's got more than one cross bracing in the box, which is very nice. You can see the ports down the bottom there. They're rounded off. But check out that crossover. Nice and beefy. It's big. Definitely decent crossover, that's for sure. But the only thing it sucks about is you can't get at it unless you totally take the speaker apart. But there's no damage to it, so I'm happy about that. Anyway, I figured I'd show you that. I'm going to put it together, glue the covers back on, and forget this ever happened. I just want to use them. Take it easy, guys.